Difficult for some to imagine, but 50 years ago, life was different. Tomorrow marks the 50th anniversary of the day President Lyndon Johnson signed into law the Civil Rights Act. That was back on July 2, 1964. That act outlawed discrimination based on race, color, religion, sex, or national origin. It also ended segregation in schools, at workplaces, and in public. With the 50th anniversary of the Civil Rights Act tomorrow, some people here in our area are taking time to reflect on the changes made and what still needs to be done. ABC News Channel 20's Brett Baldick joins us live in studio with more. Brett?
Liz, the Civil Rights Act may have been signed 50 years ago, but some locals we spoke with today say it took at least 10 years for any changes to come to Springfield. In the early 60s, many Springfield schools were segregated. That changed after the Civil Rights Act was signed, but discrimination on the streets still took place. South 11th Street, now called Reconciliation Way, was considered the dividing line between where whites and blacks were allowed to live. Ida Jackson still remembers having a white friend and going to her house for the first time.
When we went out there, the people were on their porches and they started throwing stuff at us, calling us names. And we were only like about 14, 15, and we didn't even understand it because we felt we brought her over to our house and she was accepted.
Although discrimination to that degree is now very rare, Ida Jackson says Springfield still has a long way to go. She would like to see more African-American teachers hired at District 186 and Springfield Police to hire more African-American officers. The Springfield and Central Illinois African-American History Museum is planning a program this summer to highlight civil rights and why Springfield was so late in making changes. Liz?